Hello everyone, welcome to Abhipedia, powered by Abhimanyu IAS. This is 13th lecture of our Science and Tech Value Addition series. We are covering themes and topics which are important from UPSC Prelims 2020 point of view. So once again, I am back with one of the important themes for this year prelims. This is Project Netra. Even though the word appears to be something related to medical science or some physiology, but it's I will be covering Project Netra from ISRO point of view. So this is once again under space domain like our last lecture. So I will be discussing what this Project Netra is, what is significance, and then what are the likely themes from which examiner might like to confuse you with, and a practice question to end this lecture. So why is Project Netra in news? Project Netra is in news because Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO, has signed a pact with Indian Institute of Astrophysics to set up an optical telescope under this project. And also, there is also an agreement with NIT Karnataka to set up a regional academic center for R&D purposes. So let's start what this Project Netra is. First of all, the organization, that what is the organization which is spearheading this project? It's on expected lines. Indian Space Research Organization in September 2019 has set up this project at an estimated cost of around 400 crores. And this sum is likely to go up as the project progresses. And then the components, what it's likely to be all about is, there is going to be a plethora of radar telescopes which are to be set up across the country, and there will be control centers and data processing units to process the information. So where are these four major radar and optical telescopes likely to be set up? They are in the all four domains of our. The first one is in Mount Abu in Rajasthan, the second one in Leh in north, and then Thiruvananthapuram is likely to be the third center, and in northeast the exact site is yet to be announced. So what is the need for such a project? Because India has almost dozen of communication as well as remote sensing satellites which are currently operational, and there is risk of space debris which might impact them. So all the process of Project Netra is to identify those space debris timely, and so that requisite actions could be taken. And this comes in the backdrop of our ASAT test, which also contributed to the space debris. So as a space power today, there is a need to just gauge what the effect of the space debris is, and this project will cater to that. And these services can be availed for other countries as well. So this project is not just limited to space endeavors, it has some strategic defense possibilities as well. So what is the significance of this project? This project is likely to provide impetus to SSA. This SSA term you are likely to encounter in lot of editorials from now on. This stands for Space Situational Awareness. Almost all space powers currently are working on this theme to enhance their space progress, because as I have discussed that 50 years of space exploration has contributed to lot of space debris. As we have discussed in last lecture as well, that each satellite has a shelf life of almost just 10 to 15 years. After that, it becomes a space debris, and it's a potential threat to the operational satellites. There is a chance that one space debris might collide with another one, and then the cascading effect can result in a major disaster. So we should be alert and we should be proactive in this dimension. And since we have the largest constellation of remote sensing satellites, this Project Netra is likely to cater to low Earth orbit space situational awareness. And secondly, once we operationalize such a theme, we are likely to be a stakeholder in the space governance, and we could provide this tracking as well as mitigating strategies to various nations who are interested in this. So in developing countries, no one has developed such a system. So we will once again be pioneering this theme. And this comes under broad ambit of indigenization of technology. So this is what Project Netra is. Keep following the themes which when they appear in newspaper. Now there are other project netras which can be project netra can be confused with. There are two themes which I have picked for this lecture. The first one is the netra of DRDO. Even though acronym stands for the same, in ISRO's netra acronym is for Network for Space Debris Tracking and Analysis. But DRDO netra is something different. It stands for Network for Traffic Analysis. It's a software which has been particularly developed by CAIR, Center for Artificial Intelligence Wing of DRDO, and its main theme is to analyze internet traffic and detect the suspected terms like in Skype or some Google Talk, there's a discussion going on bombs or in some likely terrorist attack. So it intercepts it. So Project Netra of DRDO is being used by our intelligence agencies RAW and IB. So make sure when this project is coming, you don't get confused with the Netra of the DRDO. Apart from that, the next UAV netra, which we had discussed in our class lectures, that should also be, you should be familiar with. UAV is unmanned aerial vehicle, and it's a light vehicle which is used for tactical purpose, for defense purposes, as it was recently used in Balakot airstrike. In 2611 as well, netra played a significant role. It is used for surveillance, intelligence gathering, data tracking, as well as in disaster management, as well as and when need arises. So make sure you are not just cramming, you are able to differentiate the different netras which are in news. Apart from that, some netra project can be associated with medical field as well, so make sure you are aware about that one as well. So this is what netra of is all about, and let's practice some question on the similar themes. So you have to pick the incorrectly matched pair out of the following. The first one is Mission Shakti, one of the options I have highlighted about Mission Shakti. Another one is Operation Smiling Buddha. So these two themes were covered in our class lecture. So this is basically your vision for you. So if you can read these options clearly, there is none of the options are correct. So here you have to pick both 1 and 2, because Mission Shakti was for ASAT test, anti-satellite test, which released the space debris, even though there was no major casualty or some an incident involving it. And today India can boost of that ASAT capability. That was another milestone. Yes, Operation Shakti was related to the nuclear, underground nuclear weapon test at Pokhran. So make sure you don't confuse Mission Shakti with Operation Shakti. And Apsara, even though was in news because we have reactivated and it was a nuclear program, but it has nothing to do with the Operation Mission Shakti or Smiling Buddha. Smiling Buddha was the first ever nuclear underground test at Operation Pokhran. Okay, so that's the four themes you should be ideally prepared with, because ASAT test was conducted this year, it can be asked. Okay. So I hope this session was useful, and I will be back soon with another lecture, and you can follow all other series as well. There is a series going on Disputed Island, there is Economy series, so keep following, the links are given in description. And for any doubts, you are most welcome to present in comment section. Thank you very much.